A quick review. The pharmacology of autonomic drugs. Sympathetic. If we look about the postganglionic sympathetic axons, we will find that in the nerve terminal, we have a co-transporter for sodium and tyrosine. Whenever tyrosine is inside the nerve terminal, it will be converted through the tyrosine hydroxylase enzyme, will be converted to DOPA. Now, DOPA, under the effect of DOPA decarboxylase, will be converted to dopamine. And then dopamine will be transported inside the vesicles by the action of vesicular monoamine transporter. Now, whenever dopamine inside vesicles, through the action of the dopamine beta hydroxylase, it will be converted to norepinephrine. Now, inside the synaptic vesicles, norepinephrine will be present in combination with adenosine triphosphate. Now, whenever the action potential will be arriving to the nerve terminal, that is going to activate specific calcium channels. We call it the voltage-gated calcium channels. So the calcium will be in. Now, the calcium and other proteins, like the one we call it vesicle-associated membrane proteins, will be letting the synaptic vesicles to join with the cell membrane and then to release the norepinephrine. The released norepinephrine will be getting through the synaptic cleft to interact with adrenoceptors, which are present in the cell membrane of the post synaptic cells and will producing its effect. The action of norepinephrine will be terminated by different method. One of them, it will be diffusing away, reaching to the blood where it will be metabolized, or even it will be metabolized before reaching to the blood. However, the major mechanism for terminating the action of norepinephrine is a through reuptake mechanism by specific transporter. We call it norepinephrine transporter that will be pumping the norepinephrine inside the nerve terminal, where it will be either rebagged with the synaptic vesicles or it will be metabolized by monoamine oxidase. Another mechanism for controlling the norepinephrine amounts is through interaction. Norepinephrine itself, it will be interacting with a receptors. Those receptors, we call it presynaptic receptors. And their function is to make an auto-regulation for the norepinephrine. So normally, that the stimulation of these presynaptic receptors will shut down further release of norepinephrine. So if we look about the endogenous catecholamines, and we mean here by the dopamine, norepinephrine, and epinephrine. If we look about it, we'll find that we have the tyrosine under the effect of tyrosine hydroxylase will be converted to DOPA. And under the effect of DOPA decarboxylase, DOPA will be converted to dopamine. And the dopamine under the effect of dopamine beta hydroxylase, it will be converted to norepinephrine. And almost all the postganglionic sympathetic nerves will be releasing norepinephrine as the neurotransmitter. Now, in some branches of the sympathetic nervous system, as the one that the postganglionic sympathetic nerve that will be terminating in the kidney, they will be releasing the dopamine as their neurotransmitters. And the dopamine will be interacting with the dopamine D1 receptors, which are present in the blood vessels. So that will be produce a dilatation of the blood vessels and will be controlling how much blood the kidney is going to filter. On the other hand, we have in the adrenal gland, we have the adrenal cortex, and we have the adrenal medulla. The adrenal medulla consider as a sympathetic ganglia. So we have here the preganglionic sympathetic nerve terminal will be ending upon the chromaffin cells. And the chromaffin cells consider as a special type of postganglionic sympathetic neurons. In these chromaffin cells, we have a specific enzyme that will be able to convert the norepinephrine to epinephrine. And then these chromaffin cells will be releasing in the blood epinephrine and norepinephrine with very little amount of dopamine. The epinephrine about like 80% and norepinephrine about 20% of the overall secretion. And now here epinephrine and norepinephrine and dopamine will be working as a hormone. So now let me summarize that we have in a few branches of the post ganglionic sympathetic nerve, which will be terminating on the kidney, they are going to release the neurotransmitter dopamine, which will be producing vasodilatation in the blood vessels that are reaching to the kidney. However, almost all the other post ganglionic sympathetic nerve will be releasing norepinephrine. And here the dopamine and norepinephrine will be working as a neurotransmitters. In the adrenal gland, we have seen that we have additional enzymes that will be converting norepinephrine to epinephrine. So the adrenal gland will be releasing norepinephrine and epinephrine, almost about 80% epinephrine, 20% norepinephrine. And here epinephrine, norepinephrine will be working as a hormone.